Welcome to the Phoenix Experience, a podcast from Pfeiffer University's longest continuous literary journal, The Phoenix. This season is all about our staff, who only talk about the best books they've encountered and their passionate opinions on topics from A to Z. Today I'm here with Kote, who is starting an Instagram.
It's an Instagram, so it's basically a photo blog.
Yeah, so Souls of Pfeiffer?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
Okay, so obviously, because I love Shayla so much, I have a little pun in my name, because that's her thing.
Thank you.
So Souls of Pfeiffer is a play on, like, our souls, obviously, but also the souls of our feet. The purpose of my photo blog is to basically bridge the gap between athletics as well as the artists that we have on campus. Both take soul, I think, and...
That's true.
Yeah. But yeah, so if you see me running around campus taking pictures of random people's shoes, your shoe could be on my page at some point this month.
Yeah, so I'm curious, why did you pick shoes of all things? And are you doing shoes for the artists as well?
Yes, I am. So I got a lot of my inspiration from the Instagram page, Humans of New York. And
oh,
it's
a
like
cool page.
Yeah, it's like a social project where you go up to a stranger. It could be somebody you know. Well, here at Pfeiffer, you know, we know everybody, so it's always going to be somebody I know. But Humans of New York, the artist goes up to random people that they find on the street and has a very informal interview. It's basically talking to get to know a stranger's story. And if they're uncomfortable with their face or anything being on the page, they take a picture of their shoe or their hand or their purse, you know, whatever it may be. And that's their identifier. And then they go and they find something that they thought was super inspiring from their talk and they highlight it on the photo blog. And I think it just really connects the community. And so when I realized that, I said, wow, there is already a divide on Pfeiffer's campus, I believe, between athletics and artists. And I would really like to bridge that because I'm a mutt of the two. I'm the mix of the both. So I would really like it if more people got on board with that. And so I chose soles, like of your feet, you know, your shoes, because I think shoes show so much personality. I mean, athletes, that's what we live in, is all athletes care about their shoes. Like, we're shoe brats, I really have to say.
But don't you have different shoes for different sports?
Well, yeah, so, like, if it's on the field, you'll have, like, a cleat, or baseball and softball have, like, different kind of cleats mm-hmm. than, like, lacrosse players do. But then basketball shoes are a lot different. And so it's all really specific to the sport, but overall, everybody wears sneakers. Like, that's, you know, sneakerheads, you know what I'm saying? And so they're automatically individual to the person. I think they show a lot of personality and what you're feeling that day and matching your shirt. And I think it's so fun. But then also artists have like their own type of thing. Like it's very unique. I love it. You know, shoes are just the window to who they are as a person. And so if I show the shoes, then nobody's going to have a problem, you know, with their face being, you know, attached to their interview. But I think shoes show as much personality as talking to somebody does.
Yeah, because obviously you walk into a shoe store or you're browsing online mm-hmm. and you're also you're looking for a shoe that speaks to you in a way. It connects to your soul. There we go. Cringy.
I knew
puns.
Shayla was going to love this pun.
Oh, puns are my thing. But yeah, I mean, shoes, I don't think I was terribly picky with shoes that much. So I was kind of like, why are you taking a picture of mine?
Spirit.
Yeah.
You know?
I like how you put that because I didn't even think about that.
That's what I'm saying. Shoes tell you so much about somebody. Like there's some shoes that if they get dirty, they have to be washed immediately. That means they like to take care of their things and they like to look fresh. If you don't care what your shoes look like and you just kind of go in with the flow, super free spirited. You know, I think everything's what you make of it.
It's almost like you're getting a little Sherlock Holmesy with the detective work. Oh, you have a fleck of dirt on your shoe. You don't care enough about your tidiness.
Yeah. Or you wore your nice shoes when it was raining outside and that was your first mistake. You know?
Your first mistake of many. Don't wear your favorite shoes out in the rain.
Never. That's a sin.
That's why we have rain boots.
Exactly.
But if you're wearing rain boots every day, you're obviously saying something.
Galoshes are life.
So I want to get your opinion on a few shoe varieties.
Okay.
Crocs.
Oh, okay. I'm the Croc queen.
Oh, so you do love Crocs?
Yes.
Okay, what do they call those little accessories? Gibbets. Gibbets. Okay, because yes. I thought they were widgets.
Gibbets.
Gibbets. Yeah. That's so weird.
My friends make fun of them and call it giblets. And I just got to the point where I just stopped correcting them. I knew what they were talking about. In my personal opinion, I brought Crocs to Pfeiffer.
You did?
Yes. If I say so myself. I came here 2.5 years ago, and I have 3 pairs of Crocs. I have white, orange, and yellow. So when I came here, nobody was wearing Crocs. So like, I didn't want to wear mine all the time. Well, when I did wear mine, people made fun of me. People were like, oh my God. You know, like the Vine, what are those? Yeah. So people, I know, but people would really roast me for wearing Crocs. And now look at everybody. I really think that I brought Crocs to Pfeiffer and scrunchies. Scrunchies. I definitely brought scrunchies to Pfeiffer.
You're wearing one right
hands
now.
Hands down. I am.
It's the prettiest teal color.
Thank you. You know, it's really just bright on this rainy day. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so another shoe variety I'm curious about are those gladiator sandals that go all the way up to your knee.
Oh.
What do you think about those?
Okay, well, I'm from the DMV. For those of you who don't know, it's like Delaware, Maryland, Virginia. Yeah, so up in the DMV, especially in like the DC, PG area, the gladiator sandals that go up to the knee in the summertime are always out. Like, they're everywhere. So, like, I don't wear them just because I don't really dress up, if we're being honest. So, like, I never really have a reason to, like, wear, like, nice sandals.
Yeah.
But I think they're interesting.
I never see them.
They're really big from where at,
yeah,
you know, like, in my area.
I see them online, on the stores all the time, and I'm like, they look cool, but I never see one wearing them, so I never get them.
Yeah, I've never really seen anybody down here wear them, I'm not gonna lie to you. But at home, like, once it hits April, May time, they're out all the time until August, I swear. They're everywhere.
Okay, and my final question regarding shoes is people who wear flip-flops year-round.
No.
No?
Absolutely not.
Okay, so we found something you don't agree with.
I cancel that. I revoke it. I send it away.
But, like, what kind of personality do you think wears flip-flops year-round, even when it's snowing, it's freezing cold?
They don't like to feel constricted, you know? Like, they don't like being tamed and, like, confined into an area. Wearing no shoes, I consider more of like a beachy, free spirit, like always shoeless type of person.
Yeah.
Which I'm like totally okay with. However, when it's raining or it's cold outside and you're wearing flip-flops, I'm low-key judging you hardcore. Hardcore. You know, that's just not good for your feet. You know what I'm saying?
Like, oh, yeah.
Like, your toes get cold. It gets dry. You got to put cocoa butter on it.
Arches are not getting supported.
Not at all. No arch support.
No.
It's,
Yeah, so is there anything else you want to tell us about Soles of Pfeiffer?
I mean, not really anything fundamentally other than, you know, what I've said about bridging the gap between campus. I think Pfeiffer has a really unique community that I really love and cherish. And I think by taking this next step just to bridge this gap and get everybody together and to realize we are all on the same page, whether we know it or not. That's super important to me, and I'm really, really stoked to get this page up and running. But other than that, I mean, just getting the chance to write and to write about my little interview, kind of sort of, quote-unquote, interviews with people is what's really exciting. We get to hear some people's stories that you never would have gotten otherwise. I get to know people that I never knew before. Because personally, writing saved me, and I think that if I can show people that writing and getting to know the community and just being vulnerable with each other, I think it'll, vulnerable in a good way, not a bad way, with people, I think that'll really transform our campus community, and then we can take it out when we leave and just be better people.
I think Cote and I would both encourage, if you're an athlete or if you're just a writer, to try those other activities. So if you write only, try some sports, try some activity, hang out with others. And also with sports, try some writing. Exercise that little noggin of yours.
Yeah. You'll be surprised at how stress relieving it is to do the things that we're not comfortable with, because now we know that we're fully capable of doing anything that we put our minds to. You know, doing something that's uncomfortable at first is always going to be weird. But then once you get done, you're like, okay, like, I just did something new. Like, this, you know, now I know whether I really liked it and never want to do it again. It's different, you know, it's like a different type of stress relief. Just trying new stuff, figuring out if you like it or not. It could be your next thing. You never know.
Yeah, and if you found that you hated it in the past, try it again. you might have noticed that you've changed. Even regardless of how you feel about writing or sports or anything, try it anyway.
You learn a new appreciation for the things that you've never tried before. If you try it, you learn a different, a newfound appreciation for it. And I think that's really important in part of being a good human being is whether you enjoy something or not, if you can appreciate it, that shows more of your character than anything else.
Yeah, and I think we all hope to see that reflected in your blog.
I hope so, thank you.
Yeah, so thanks for coming in.
Of course, I'm Cote. Shout your girl out.
Yeah, and you can check out her Instagram blog, Souls of Pfeiffer.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Not a student at Pfeiffer. Love books filled to the brim with riveting poems, fiction, and creative nonfiction pieces? Then pre-order our 60th anniversary edition of The Phoenix and brag to all your friends that you're holding a rich piece of history. For more info, check our link in the description.